learning. Today, I'm going to show you around El Karama. And we're going to do one activity we can do here, which is called Plaster of Paris, which is basically doing a 3D print of an animal's footprint. Then we put the Plaster of Paris in, it dries, we go back and we get the footprint as a 3D model. It's really cool. This is the Plaster of Paris that we're going to use to make the pot. Also, I forgot to mention we need water to make it moisty and then it can dry. And this is Robinson, my friend.
Hello.
We're now looking for the paw prints for the Plaster of Paris. And on the way, we're probably going to see some animals, like zebra and impala. Oops. Not bush pig, but warthog. What do you mean, a baby one? It's a baby. So right now Robinson is looking for good tracks for us because they're easier to find at the river because if the water has already because it's mud and then the footprint gets deeper and then we can see it more clearly.
It has stuff inside.
I found a buffalo footprint right there. It looks like two little human feet on a line together, but a bit far away, like that. These are warthogs. Or warthog footprints. So we're going to another dam now, and we're gonna look for other footprints because I don't really want a buffalo or warthog footprint. There's some lion footprints right here. Right here are lion footprints. This is a lion footprint. So this is a front, sorry, this is a back leg and this is a front. I know it's kind of weird how that's the back and that's the front, but the lion steps here and then with its back leg it stepped there. And the reason this one is more like circular and more stuff like that is because it holds more weight because of like the head and the chest and then all the muscle. And this is the back leg, which only supports maybe this part. Is it the waist? It supports the waist and the and a little bit of muscle and the tail. So that's why this is more long and slender and this is fatter and deeper. So these footprints are 2 weeks old because the last time it rained was 2 weeks ago and you need mud, as I said, to get a very good footprint. So now Robinson is cleaning them for us so the Plaster of Paris doesn't get all like those darts, which are annoying. Now they are clean. So the Plaster of Paris goes in here.
People say that we're born with a purpose. And that we're meant to make our dreams come true. But if our dreams start to...
Doesn't look very good, does it? So now we write our names so we know it's ours. So this will be Katie. I'm gonna do a K for Katie. Mine, so I get the E. And those are our paw prints. That's incredible, it's already dry. Don't want to ruin the footprint. Right now it doesn't look very good. We get a twig and we clean. Oh, wow.
They say that nobody changes, but I'm living proof that they
Shout out to El Karama. It's the best safari lodge ever. There's so many activities you can do, like bush school, fishing, and this. You can also make bracelets. And brownies. The reason I have to use a twig to clean it like this is because if it goes under the sink, this thing will dissolve, which I really don't want to happen. If you want one of these, come to El Karama. Bye guys, remember to subscribe and give this video a big thumbs up. I hope you have a nice day and you can come to El Karama, swim, play football, to play table tennis, and eat. Bye!